I should buy a mill.
To be precise, I want a cheap mini mill that I can put on my table and prototype some PCBs. I'm no expert, and this video simply documents all the experience I made in the first 2 days of using it. I did several mistakes and did some silly things, so it might be worth watching till the end. First, what I did is to look for a really cheap but sturdy milling machine on AliExpress. I found this one, which has warehouses all over the world. About $140 for a weekend project seems reasonable, and if it isn't anything, I can simply salvage the parts. I put a link in the description. The package arrived within 5 days, so let's crack it open. The mill comes as a kit. It's like Lego for grown-ups. All parts are included. Even some tools. Delicious. The Z-axis is already assembled. Some parts seem to be nylon, and then we have some aluminium extrusions and some steel parts. The controller board comes with some standard drivers and runs the open source Gerbil firmware. The instructions and the software are shipped on a CD. Really? Fortunately, I found an ancient optical drive in my drawer. So let's check out what's on it. We have an open source CAM software, some test files, a user manual, and the build instructions. I will print them for convenience. If you bought this and don't have an optical drive, ask me on the Discord server, I will give you the files. Okay, we are ready, so let's start the assembly. Okay. The whole assembly took me about 2 hours without any complications.
Oh wow! Ha!
So let's test it. Okay, that needs some lubrication. I also added some pads to reduce the noise. In hindsight, rubber pads would be better so it doesn't slide around while milling. Oh yeah, much better.
Okay.
This is one of the test files. I'm not sure what's saying. They could really troll me here. For the first test, I let it run without any tool and workpiece.
Whoa!
Shipped with the machine was a set of these conical molds. Let's try it out. It's so pointy, I don't want to have this in my eye. Safety first. I will try cardboard first. After setting the origin, I was ready to test it.
Okay, let's start.
I was really surprised how seamless everything works without any calibration. Not sure how true the dimensions are though. Let's take a moment to talk about this chuck here. What I actually ordered was this super cheap mount there. But what I got is the ER11 chuck. Usually that option costs $50 extra. I'm not sure what happened there. Maybe I was lucky or they simply don't care. But they also gave me this useless US cable, so we are even. $50 for the ER11 chuck are a little bit exaggerated. You must know I planned building such a router before. And I have all the parts needed already in some abandoned project boxes around here. So I actually know that this ER11 chuck with 5mm shaft diameter costs only about $10. So don't take the ER11 option from the seller of this CNC mill. While I was shopping back then, I also got some mills. I have the pointy ones already, but I also got this 60 degree ones here. I wanted to try different types. I got also a set of these chinesium end mills here for $7. We will test them all in this video. I put also the link to the chuck and the mills in the description below. Okay, let's try milling an actual PCB. I don't have any software recommendations yet, but Inkscape comes with a G-code tools extension. The tools are a little bit cumbersome to use, but you can get a start here. This is the path that's generated. Loaded in the CAM tool, it really looks good. Using that G-code might generate some warnings, but you can ignore them. Okay, first I set the X and Y origin. But before we start milling, I will put this whole thing in a case. This is a cheap-ass server rack from eBay. I simply don't want to have this fiberglass and copper flying around my lab. Okay, a smaller rack would do it. Z origin is set, and let's start.
Okay, it's clearly engraved, but the tip is gone, so I will replace that.
Since the pointy one broke, I decided to use the 60 degree mill instead. But in hindsight, the pointy one are perfectly fine. I just needed to crank up the RPMs and maybe use a slower feed rate. But we will see this later. Let's take a look how this turns out. You can imagine I was really happy with the first milled copper. Even though the copper was a little bit ripped, I was keen to try an actual PCB. I exported one of my designs as an SVG file, imported it in Inkscape, fixed all the issues, and the toolpath calculations took noticeably longer. Look at this mess! But loaded in the CAM tool, it really looks reasonable. So, let's do it! We'll be right back. Okay, this is not what I imagined. The grooves seem to be too wide. Traces are gone. Yeah, that's not usable. I was ready for another round with the pointy tip again. And this time I put a sacrificial HDF plate beneath the PCB so I'll be able to mill the holes and the contours. This is the new test file and let's go! Okay, 1/10 of a millimeter was too shallow without probing the surface. And also the traces were too thin and were gone as well. And I also managed by accident to plunge the tip into the workpiece. You wouldn't believe the tip actually survived. Still, I wanted to test the milling of the holes and the contours. I changed the tool and continued. For the toolpath, I used 1/2 a millimeter per pass. That takes really long with that slow feed rate that I have used. We will try to improve this in the next round. The holes looked already nice. The contours next. I used a 2 mm tool for that and 1 mm per pass. Let's go! Okay, let's check the results. Milling the holes and the contours went really well, but I need to respect the milling tolerances in my design. So with the pointy tip, we need at least 0.4 millimeters clearance around all traces, and the traces have to be thicker. But I'm really satisfied with the pads. 1/10 of an inch pin headers shouldn't be a problem. My new design had 0.8 millimeter traces and 0.5 millimeter clearance. Let's try this. And there is another mistake. I milled the holes too shallow by a copy-paste mistake. And while wanting to recycle the toolpath, I set the Z-origin lower, but the travel height was really shallow and the mill broke off. So another one bites the dust. Okay, new mill, new luck. Since I want to find out the limits, I will mill the contour in one go, without any tabs. That was actually really thrilling! And the board actually looks usable. Okay, I messed up the through hole pads, But as you can see, the surface mount pads and the tracers look really well. 0603 SMD shouldn't be a problem. So I think I can actually use it for prototyping. I only need to respect the limits in my designs. Okay, you guys are interested in the limits of the machine. Let's try some aluminium. Okay, let's try again. Okay, the pros might be cringing since this end mill isn't the proper tool for that. It more like melted its way through the aluminium. But that's a huge success for me to get there in 2 days. I think it's sturdy enough and didn't get the impression that it isn't up for the job. I just need to collect a little bit more experience with that. So in the few tests that I've done, I definitively can say that it's up for the task to mill PCBs. And that was actually my intention. What do you think? Do you have any recommendations for a good software? I will continue improving my skills on that and I will update you from time to time, so subscribe to not miss it. Thanks to all my supporters and I see you next time. Bye!